What is up guys, Vortex here, and today I'm back with a bunch of games from locals, and in this game it will be me playing D-Brigade and my opponent playing MetalGarurumon. My opponent was testing out an interesting version of MetalGarurumon, and I think it went pretty well, I won't lie, but I get the start, so I'm already at a massive advantage as it is, so I get to play a Commandramon in Raising, and then get to play the Pride Memory Boost, allow myself to play Hagurumon, getting its on play to discard and draw two. So my opponent is now on his turn. He's playing the Upamon, which I find quite interesting. I didn't really think much of it, but actually getting a draw sometimes over the 1k boost is what most people do. Maybe the draw is actually better just to make it more consistent, but who knows? We'll see in the gameplay, I guess. But he then plays the blue memory boost. And now he's considering what he wants to do next. And I think at this point I think he's just contemplating just digivolving into the Gururu, but he decides to go into the Gabumon, get a search for the Sagittarius mode. And so it's my turn now, so I get to promote the Commandramon. I swing into security, it lives, and I swing in with the Hagurumon, it dies. So having the Commandramon stay here is okay. It just really depends on if he wants to attack into it. I discard the Pride Memory Boost here to play Izzy Azumi, revealing the top three. And yeah, so this is a pretty good reveal for the top three. However, it does give my opponent a lot of information just due to the fact that, well, the Darkdramon is there. I decided to keep it in the normal stat that I was at. And as you can see in my hand, I do have another Darkdramon. So a little bit of a heads up play here, potentially. And so what I decided to do is just play the on deletion Commandramon here just to apply some more pressure. I know MetalGaru, as I've played a lot of it so far, tends to just return stuff. However, I want to apply pressure, so I just had to play it. And so he promotes into the draw Gabu. He goes into the Gabu X-Antibody, searches, gets the X-Antibody, and he also gets the WereGaruru X-Anti. So really good search there for sure. And so he swings at security, gets an additional draw, and it dies. But hey, the draw could actually end up mattering here. It's very interesting, the Upamon, actually. Maybe it's something I'll consider for like future gameplay videos, but yeah, I just find it quite interesting, to be fair. So he goes into Guru and then Guru X Antibody. He's just counting up how many D-Brigade cards I have in my discard. He swings into the Commandramon. He obviously knows the stack, so he gets rid of the Tamer on top. Not really necessary at this point, because I think he's not going to do much anyways. And he plays another blue memory boost. So he goes into, picks up the Gabu X antibody in this situation. And so I have another body on board, so it helps me out here. So I go on the Commandramon, it hits, and I get the BT-03K Commandramon. It does mean that the Darkdramon ends up leaving the stack, but I don't have a level 3 in hand, which sucks, but I kind of wanted to apply more pressure. So at this moment, I'm just considering what do I really want to do, and for me, it's playing the Darkdramon, so I return the top 5. I really wish I had the other Darkdramon in the trash so I can get it back, but I swing into the Garurumon because I know that he has the WereGaruru, so I need to get rid of this. It is a problem card for me, and I play another Izzy Azumi, revealing, and then just keeping the top cards because I already know the result because they're the Commandramons I put on top. And so he's just counting up again. I'm opening up a monster because branding, I guess. He goes into a Guru X antibody, then goes into the Garurumon. It goes to a Guru X antibody. So he has a really good stack here. It just depends if you'll be able to end up dealing with my Darkdramon. He goes to the WereGaruru. He then trashes another one. Goes into the Hammer Spark there. And then he decides to Kakadis Breath it back to the hand because he obviously knows I don't really have any targets. So ends up being very powerful in this situation. But it doesn't answer my level 3. So I have a level 3 in hand, and as you can see in my hand, I also have the Ultimate Flare just in case I want to answer basically his board. So I swing at Security. It's another Hammer Spark, which really sucks in this situation because it limits my play, basically. I took it to the discard for some reason, but it stays on the field, so my mistake. And so I just end up playing the Izzy and Joe because from the gameplay that he's shown me, it seems like he is willing to just play a level 3. So avoiding that for future turns, I think, is very powerful. And having an additional draw, because I already know the top 5 cards on my deck, be dealt with to draw. And so there's another Digimon. So at this moment, my opponent obviously has a lot of information. He knows that one of them is at the bottom of the deck, one is in my hand, and one has just been trashed. So there's only really one, just X1, basically. And so he goes into Sagittarius mode. I thought you could return it, but you need a Tamer in play, so I forgot about that completely. He then goes into the X-Antibody. And so obviously at this point he has the Security Attack plus 1. From his Analog Boy. Very interesting collection of cards here. but I think in the end he will go just for the BT-05 Searcher Gabu. The rest goes to the trash. And I believe he's going to swing at Security. He's considering swing at Security. And then goes into the X-Antibody, returning the Commandramon to my hand. The first check is Sealsdramon, and the second check is a Commandramon. So pretty good for him in this situation. He then is considering, does he want to swing into it? I think at this point he's just worried if he swings into the Security again, I get enough for another Digimon play, basically. So he definitely wants to avoid that. But at the same time, I think he ends up risking it because at this point, I have it or not, basically. So he swings at Security. It's a Grumblemon, which is something that I don't want to see because Grumblemon is something that I desperately need. He then plays Ice Wall to stop my turn, or my plays, really. So I'm just considering what I want to do at this situation. And I think I have a good understanding of what I want to do. I want to promote, I want to swing at Security. It ends up being this plug-in card. It's another card I've actually been considering just due to the fact that it gives you Security Attack plus 1. And it also gets you a search as well when Security, but I don't know, not too sure how I feel about it at the moment. And then I hard play Ultimate Flare because I can't really answer the Where Guru X Antibody. I give him a lot of memory this turn, unfortunately, but I can't really do much at this point. And so he goes to the Gabumon he searched, then to the Garuru, and this is just the case of like every Metal Guru list. Like as soon as you get like all the cards, like, as soon as you draw a lot of the cards, you basically just have the answer to everything. You can go back into your stacks very quickly, but in this situation I believe he's hesitating because he doesn't have the Guru X Antibody. So this moment he's just trying to do some calculations and he ends up just returning it back to hand because he has to play to his outs, basically. And so I end up going to the Commandramon. Just considering what I want to do, I have free memory here, so I do have some options here. So I end up playing the 2-cost Commandramon, and then I Digivolve on top of it for the Sealsdramon, giving him 1. So basically, this limits him a lot because he only has 4k. He has to go into the X Antibody, which I know he doesn't have, otherwise he'd hard play it by now. I could just block at that point, and he's playing Upamons, which means he doesn't get the DP boost. But he ends up actually having the X Antibody. I think he was waiting for potentially like a cool boy, maybe. So at this point, he's just considering what he needs to do, and he ends up scooping that game. Okay, and we get into game 2. My opponent will be starting off first. So he goes into the Upa, then the Gabu, and then he gets the blue memory boost. Ends up taking the Madoki because that's the only target there. But it's a really good target against my deck specifically. So I end up going next. Go into the Pagumon, into the Commandramon here. Block of Commandramon is okay in this matchup. but it's not really utilized at all this term, this game. And so my Izzy Azumi is very interesting. I definitely do obviously value the Defexmon in this matchup, because if I could just de-digivolve one, he can't really do much, and then I can potentially delete. So really good for me. And so I have a really good setup here. He swings and then hits into the Grumblemon, which means he doesn't really get much from it, but he does get a draw. He then plays a Cool Boy, and this is where he says, "This is why I hate Cool Boy." And to be honest, I kind of agree. When you get Cool Boy and you're playing and you're winning, it feels really good. But when you get into those situations where you mill cards, well, not mill cards, reveal cards, and they're all cards you're like, that would be really nice to have. It feels really bad. But it's my turn, so I swing at Security, hit an Analog Boy. And then he gets another Madoki swing, and dies to the Gabumon. Considering what I want to do now, basically, have a lot of memory to play with. He just asked me to reveal what card I added from the Pagumon, I believe. I end up playing the Kazu. I feel like I should have played this earlier, because I could have cycled a little bit more earlier, but I was just doing it just in case of the Hammer Spark, because obviously I know he plays Hammer Spark, I know he plays X-Antibody. So he decides to pop the memory boost, play another Gabu to get a draw. He then goes into the Guru for one, and then goes to the X antibody, gets a draw and a memory. And this is why I like Cool Boy. It's sometimes good, because that whole evolution line just became basically free, and it also gets you an additional draw. So Cool Boy, it's good, but sometimes it sucks when you don't get what you want. He swings with Madoki, and I hit into a Chikurimon. So it digivolves the X antibody, which is pretty good for me, because it just means that he has less protection on the following turn, unless he actually has another X antibody, obviously. He then ends his turn by playing Davis, revealing the top cards. He ends up adding the Wergururu, because obviously, why wouldn't you add the Wergururu at this point? So my turn starts, go to 4. I play the Commandramon. I was just checking to see, like, oh, am I at 4 or 5? Because I don't know. I swing at Security, hits into a Gabu, hits into another Gabu. Suspended, gets what, so I get to draw and discard, and just discarding the Chikurimon, because I think that's what my hand was at the moment, and I end up playing Defexmon to clear his board, because yeah, I mean, he played a lot of tamers, had a lot of the board went wide, so I felt like it was just the best play, chance to play, obviously. So at this point he actually has quite a lot of memory to play with, so he also has the Cool Boy, but having the Madoki is, this is the reason why I don't really like playing Madoki, but it also feels like you need to play Madoki. Yeah, because it's just not a Gabumon, so you don't get the Cool Boy effects, basically. So, and you always want to get the Cool Boy effects. So at this point, he's just considering what he wants to do, because at this point, I believe he probably has the level 4. Can he get into level 5? Probably not. So that's where we're at the moment. He could attempt to clear the Commandramons, but I don't think that's really necessary if he has the Sagittarius mode. So he goes into the X antibody, and he's just trying to play to his outs, basically. So I believe he ends up actually going into the Sagittarius mode very shortly, because that's the only realistic play he has. Really sucks when you end up like not getting all the cards you particularly want, but I believe this is where he plays it. He goes Hammer Spark. I believe this is where he said it's actually, if he had another Hammer Spark, it would be game. So makes sense. But I think my Security had something in it. I think he had like another Defexmon, and it doesn't have protection, so. Would see. So he goes Ice Wall to block me off, and then goes into the Sagittarius mode to return the two Commandramons. I push up, and then basically he's just hoping for Hammer Spark. I swing, it's nothing, and then it's good games.